السلام عليكم سر.
وعليكم السلام. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear students, I hope that all of you are fine and studying at home and giving
Yes, sir.
time to your studies. Okay. So, you know that in the month of May, we are going to have our monthly exam as well, which will be, of course, online. And I would like to tell you that, and I have already informed you about it, that this time the exam will be conducted using Google Classroom. And you know that we are doing the practice as well for Google Classroom. And you know, last time I had given you some small tasks, you know, in your Google Classrooms, so that you should have some practice and you must be familiar with the environment of the classroom and how to submit assignment. You know that when the exam will be conducted, so Salam. Okay. When the exam will be conducted, so the exam will be online, and the MCQs and the short questions that will be there in your paper. So MCQs will also be on a on an electronic form, and the short questions will also be submitted using Google Classroom. But of course, short questions you will have to write on paper, and then you will submit either images or you will submit the PDF file. Okay, so I hope that this thing is clear. I would also like to give you an MCQ sample test as well, so that we must have the practice for doing MCQs as well, and the practice for doing short questions. How to submit short questions, we are already doing this practice. So last time I had given one assignment, and still I am able to see that only I think one student has submitted this assignment, which is that you need to write, define the following terminologies: database, database management system, fields, records, and primary key. Okay, this is the assignment that you are supposed to do, but still the students have not submitted. One student has submitted. Are you facing any problem? Please let me know. Or you did not do because of you could not manage the time, or are you facing some technical issue why you have not submitted the assignment that I had given you last time? Similarly, practical assignment I had given that you will make in MS Access and then you will submit. So one student, Ahmed Malik, has submitted only one file. What about the rest of the students? You know, just like this, when you will submit it to me, I will download it. Right now I'm downloading. Okay, I will download the file, and then I will be able to, just like Ahmed Malik's file has been downloaded, you know, in my PC, and then I will be able to open this file. When I will go to my downloads, I will be able to see that what kind of work he has done. So practical assignment, one assignment I had given to you, and one assignment I had given to you, which is basically for the short questions. Okay, this is the table that he has made. He has entered three records over here as well. Okay, for ID, employee ID, first name, last name, email, designation, department, salary. Ahmed, will you tell me why did not you rename the table name? Will you unmute yourself? Your mic is not coming to me over here. It is not visible. You see your mic first and then connect again. So we can rename the table over here by right clicking the table. When we'll right click the table, there is rename option. We can rename the table over here. Okay, after closing the tables, data sheet view, we can right click on it, we can go and we can rename it, just like if I want to write it over here employee. So the table name should be employee. You had given a random table name, so table name should be relevant. This thing is very important for us. Okay, so I hope that this point is clear to all the students. And what about the rest of the students? I would like to know. Just let me close the screen sharing. All the students, just open the cameras as well. Open the cameras. Yes, please. Open the cameras. I would like to know that what is the problem, that why you did not submit the assignment. You people are not studying in Ramadan. You are not giving time. What is the problem? Or you face some technical issue while submitting. You are unable to know how to submit. I had shown you the process. If still there is problem, then I can explain this thing to you again. This is very important for us, okay? Because we have to move towards the next chapter, and I have given you some assignments over here. So definitely, it's very important for us. Yes, please. Muhammad Saad, will you please tell me about it? Why did not you do the assignment? Muhammad Saad, unmute yourself. Yes, you can unmute yourself. Yes. Why you have not submitted the assignment number one, which is to define, only you have to define some small terminologies, what is data, database, database management system, the things like that. Yes. Yes. I am unable to listen to you. See that your mic pin is attached properly. Abu Zar, all these students should open the mics and just let me know, and also open the cameras as well. Abu Zar. Muhammad Shaviz.
Sir, I don't have PC.
You don't have PC, you can submit using cell phone. If you don't have the PC, you will write on paper. This thing I have explained you, that you will write on paper, you will take the image. You will take the image. Then you will submit that image to me using Google Classroom.
Sir, my Google Classroom was reset.
If it is reset, does not matter. You just log in by that email ID that you had used to log in. Then you will be able to see.
Sir, I don't have the class code.
If I have shown the class code a number of times. Anyway, I will show you the class code right now as well. This is a lame excuse, I think. 100 times I have shown the class code. Yes, Asad Riaz. Asad Riaz. Unmute yourself, Asad Riaz. And why your camera is not open when I am saying that the camera should be open? Yes, why you have not submitted the assignment, which is a written assignment, you have to write on paper and you have to submit the images. Yes. Will you please tell me about it? If you will not do the practice for it, how you are going to attempt your first monthly test in May, which is now scheduled in May, most probably from 20th or 25th. So what you will do if you are not doing it right now, how will you do the practice? Why you are not doing the assignments? What kind of action I'll have to take? I will have to call the parents, or what will I have to do in order to bring you people towards the on-time submission of assignment? Yes, Rehan Fida, will you please tell about it? Yes, please. Ahmed, you have also not submitted the written assignment. Ahmed. Faik Fazal. Ali Yusuf. So I am just giving you the day, which is today. I'm just giving you one day, today. Today I need this assignment, okay? I need this assignment. I'm going to share the screen over here. See, this assignment is given in your this one, assignment chapter 1, introduction to Access, and you have to submit it over here. These are the small definitions: database, database management system, fields, records, and primary key. And these answers are also given, you know, in your book. You have to find it out from there and you have to submit it over here. One student which is submitted, basically it is myself. I had shown you the demo how to submit. I hope that this process is clear to all these students. Okay. So now we move towards, once again, we move towards our work. And you know that this chapter is done and we have to see the question and answers which that I had already shared with you, but we will go through anything which is left over here. Naming field name, how to set up the names of the fields. This thing is already discussed and I had explained you. Practically, I'm explaining you each and everything so that there should not be any confusion. How to create a database, how to open a database, how to add, move, hide, unhide records, you know, all these things I had explained you. Now we have to see some points which are given over here: totaling, sorting, filtering, and searching data. Now this is the thing that we are going to see over here. How to apply this thing? Okay, how to apply this thing, that how you can make total, how you can make sort, how you can make filter, how you can search data in your table. Fine. So this is the thing that we are going to do. For this purpose, I am going to open one table, one database, so that this point should be clear to all these students, because when we are doing our work, of course, we need to have hands-on practice and we must have a proper concept of the work that we are doing. Okay, just like this is an example in front of you. This is an example. If I need to add one table, one record over here, okay, I'm deleting the extra columns over here, which are not required. So I can delete from here. This is the table which is already developed. What are the fields you can see over here? How to remove extra records? Just like this is not a proper record. I had just shown you last time how to add new fields. So that's why it is appearing over here. So I am deleting. Right click on the raw and click on delete button. Right click on the raw and click on the delete button. Okay. So this is what we are doing over here. Now I am entering one test marks. Test marks I am taking over here in number. Test marks in number. One test is there for which the students appeared, and I am giving the marks over here in number. Now, when we will open the table, now this test is there. I am giving some marks to the students out of 100. Let's suppose 67, 78, 89, 56, 60, 78. Okay, these are the enough. Now, if you need to sort the record. Sorting means you know that I had applied sorting ascending or descending order. So we can sort the records by number, by character, using any way. Let's suppose there are some name. If you want to sort the records by name, you will click name column, you will click, and you can sort ascending. Okay, you can see this group, which is sort and filter. So if I click on sort ascending, now you can see that Ahmed is coming in the beginning. Okay, if I click on descending, then you can see that Shahzad is coming in the beginning, then Nadeem, then Bilal, then Ali, then Ahmed. If I click on the ascending sort, so you can see that over here we are sorting according to the alphabets. Those alphabets which are coming in the beginning, we are able to see when we are clicking on ascending order. So it is starting from A. When we are clicking on descending order, then it is starting from last character, whatever it is. Now, similarly, we can sort using numbers. For example, if I want to see highest numbers in the beginning, so I will click on sort descending, but I have selected the test column now. 89, then 78, then 50, 67, then 56, then 34. If I will click on, and you can see over here, 89 are there for Bilal, 78 are there for Shahzad, 67 are there for Ali. So this is how we can sort. So what does it mean? How you are going to write on your paper? Okay, it should be very much clear to you. Okay. Now you can see over here, we are right now on page number 15. Okay. So in page number 15, we are discussing about totaling, sorting, filtering, and searching of data. All these operations are there that we are going to do. Now see what is meant by sorting. This is clear. Will you please give me the feedback about by thumbs up? Or what is meant by sorting? Arranging data in order, ascending order or descending order. This is called sorting. This thing is clear or not? What is written over here? You can sort the information in the table on the based on the values. Okay. So we can make the sorting possible just because of the data which is available over there. So this thing is clear or not? Will you please give me feedback about it, that this point is clear, how to sort the data? Thumbs up. I need to see the thumbs up that you are clear about. We can apply sorting on one column. Okay, we will apply sorting on one column, and we will select that column, and then we will apply the sorting. If you want to sort the names, you can do it using names, you can do it using marks, you can do it using serial number, roll number, whatever the field you want to take, you can sort it. Arrangement of data in ascending or descending order, or from small to high, or high to small value. This is clear or not? What is meant by filtration? What is meant by filter? Now see, I am going to explain you filter. Filter means, if you want to apply some specific filter. So for example, you can see over here, enrolled status. Some students are there who are enrolled, and some are there who are not enrolled. Similarly, let me show you another example in order to explain the filter. If I right click and open it, the table in design view, I add one more option, which is class. Okay, class I am taking over here in the short text. Okay, now see the example. I have entered the class. Some students are there in, let's suppose, 8th B. Some students are there in 9B. Okay. Just giving you the example. Some students are there in 9B. Some students are there in 7B. There are different students in different classes. There may be hundreds of students. I am just giving you the example of a table where are 6-7 records. So if you need to apply the filter, how you are going to apply the filter? How it is possible? If you need to see only 9 grade students or only 7 grade students, so how we are going to do this thing? We will click over here the column name and we will click on filters. You can see over here that the filter comes over here. What do you want to see? You can unselect the data and you will click on, let's suppose 8B only. So now you will see that there is only one student from 8B. Now I have filtered the data. It does not mean that the rest of the students have been deleted. No. The rest of the students are not deleted. You will see one funnel sign. You can see this small funnel sign, which is not available with any of the columns over here. Can you see this small funnel sign? This thing is clear?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay. So this small funnel sign is showing that we have applied filter. We can click on it and we can click on select all and okay. So all records are visible. If I go there on this column, if I click on this option filter and I want to see 9B students only. Okay. So now you can see that over here, there are 2 students from 9B. So 9B students have been filtered. For example, if there are 1000 records, I'm just giving you example, and there are 40 students from 9B. So all 40 students of 9B will appear. This is filtration. This thing is clear or not? This thing is clear or not? Please tell me about it. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I want to see those students who are enrolled and those who are not enrolled, I can click on this option and I can go to filter. I want to see where check marked is there. Yes. Okay. Only those where check marked is there, who are enrolled, these are now visible. If I need to see those students who are not enrolled, so what I will do, I will go and I will click on no. I just want to see where there is no check mark, means where the answer is no. So then in this situation, I can see that answer accordingly. So the filter is applied where there is similar type of data. You know, always filter will be applied over there. Okay. Just like city, if I go over here in this table, let me show you one example. I go to design view. I take one more field, city, short text. Okay. Now, I'm entering some cities over here, just like Karachi, Multan, Lahore, Islamabad. Okay. Now, if I want to see only students from Lahore, I will click the city. I will go to filter and I will unselect all. I will click on only Lahore. Now, only students from Lahore are visible. They may be in different classes. Okay. We can apply multiple filters as well. If I want to see that all students who are from Lahore, but who are in class, let's suppose class 6. Let me select all over here. Okay. Now if I apply the filter on class, okay, so I can click over here. Let's suppose I want to see only from 8B. Now these are the students. Now over here you can see that it has already been filtered. According to class, city, we can apply the filter. I hope filter is clear. Will you please give me the feedback that the point about filter is clear now? How to filter data? This thing is clear or not? Now come towards, please give me the feedback. Now, sorting is clear, filtering is clear, searching. Searching is also very important. Searching. searching for data, how you are going to search for data, how the search will be applied. First, I am going to remove the filter from here so that all records should be visible. Now I will go to where you want to search. In name you want to search, where you want to apply the search. This thing is very important over here. So you will be able to see that use the search box. Okay, at the bottom of the access screen, enter part of or all of the word that you want to search. You will see over here, you will see over here one box is given over here. Are you able to see? At the bottom there is one box given over here for the search. What do you want to search? If I say that I want to search Ali, you can see over here the Ali is visible now. Okay, you can apply search in and you can apply search anywhere. When I wrote Khan, so wherever Khan will come, it will be highlighted. Okay, if I write, let's suppose 78, so you can see that 78 is there in the marks, test marks. So 78 is highlighted. Sometime it will happen that the thing that you are searching is coming two or more times. So you will be able to see that right now it is giving you over here, but Lahore, just like Lahore is there in this column, so we will be able to see that it is there on multiple places. So when we will press enter, we will be able to see the next locations as well. Just like this is first Lahore, when I will enter, so then second Lahore will also come, that there the Lahore is also available over here as well. So this is how we can put the data, and data will be searched, whether it is city or name or student first name, last name, whatever it is, the data will be searched automatically and you'll be able to see address. For example, if you want to type the address, let's suppose I am typing over here D56. Okay, D65, D56. So D56 is coming over here in this address of Shahzad. This thing is clear now about the searching. Searching is clear or not? Will you please give me the feedback? Okay, keep yourself unmuted. Muted. Yes, please give me the feedback about it. Okay. Okay. So I think now filter is clear, searching is clear. Now we come towards the option which is calculation in data sheet view. Now see, what is meant by calculation in data sheet view? How we can make calculation? Where do you need to make calculation? Will you please tell me about it? Yes. Please raise the hand. Where calculation is involved? Can you tell me about this table? Is there any column where we need to do any calculation? Sometimes not in this column, but if I need to calculate, for example, if one student is there who has got some, you know, there are multiple students available over here. So if you need to count them, if you need to apply the total of the students, so we can do this thing as well quite easily. Now, how we can apply this thing, total? Click on the total in the records group on the home tab. Okay, and then you will be able to see that how many, what is basically the total of that particular thing. Okay, so over here you can see over here we will have to use option which is total option. Okay, when I click the test marks and I clicked on the totals, now it is showing me that I can calculate the sum of all these marks. Okay, I can calculate the average of all these marks. I can count them. How many are they? For example, if I count them, these are 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is counting. If I click on sum, so this is the sum of 67, 89, 87, 78, 56, 34. If I click on average, now average of these all marks, if we will add them and we will divide by 6, how many are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? So then the average will be this 64.8. Similarly, if I want to find out the maximum value, then maximum value is 89 over here in this column. If I need to find out minimum value, then the minimum value is 34 in this column. This is what we can apply to a numerical column that we are using. This thing is clear. When we click on the total function, so then we are able to apply all these functions. When we click on the totals, so we can not only take sum, average, count, minimum, maximum, okay? Other statistical items are also there, which are standard deviation and variance, but these five are very important for us. So this is basically about calculations. What kind of calculations are there that we can do? For example, I click on the first name, okay? And over here, I want to apply total. So over here, you can see only count is coming. Why? Because names are in characters. So we cannot find out the average of names. We cannot find out the sum of names, you know, maximum, minimum. We can only find out the number of items available, number of names available in this column. So this is how we are going to do it. Fine, this thing is clear. Yes, students, I need feedback. What we have covered today? What we have covered today? Our last class was on on 29th we had our class and we had some revision, you know, some important things that we studied on 29th anyway. So I'm going to apply on 29th April as well. I had given you the Google introduction explanation of nation of Google Classroom. This was done on 29th of April. Okay. And then today, what we have done today, this is 2nd May. And what we did today, we have applied totaling, total functions. Okay, then search, filter, and sort. Okay, these are the tasks that we have done today. Fine. Done on 2nd May. So I hope that you will do the practice of all these things, and you know that homework and assignments I am also uploading in your classroom for this chapter. Then when we have to move, inshallah, in next class, because this chapter is done now, we have to move towards next class, and the next class will be, of course, for chapter number 2, and these two chapters are going to come in your first monthly test, chapter number 1 and chapter number 2. You must be aware of this fact. Okay, this thing is clear to all these students. Thank you so much, all of you.